Grounded from Obsidian had a super successful launch day yesterday, and we're going to talk about it. We're going to discuss it. What does this mean for the Xbox? What does this mean for Xbox first party titles? Doesn't mean anything at all. But before we jump into that, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to this channel. We are all Xbox One all the time. We are the XoneBros. We've got you covered with podcasts, news, discussions. We are a higher plane of thought here at the XoneBros. Hit that like button, subscribe to us, and let's do this. So Xbox critics have complained that Xbox just doesn't have the games. But what Xbox does have is successful games, as proven by Obsidian's new game Grounded that just released yesterday. It released to a wide, wide audience. This is a news story over at purexbox.com. Obsidian's Grounded officially launched into early access on Xbox One and PC yesterday. And even though the full game doesn't properly release until 2021, it's already off to a fantastic start. At one point yesterday, it was actually the second most popular game on Twitch, racking up over 250,000 consecutive views. That actually did put it above League of Legends for a time, but that's not even where it's big. It also made its way into the Steam bestseller list, with SteamDB suggesting it currently has an all-time peak of 12,543 players on the service, with many more likely to have been playing with Xbox Game Pass for PC. And of course, the game was also made available on the Xbox Game Pass for consoles yesterday. Everybody I knew was playing it. Game Pass is huge for this game, but more importantly, games like this are huge for Game Pass. Grounded instantly sucks you in. I had a chance to jump in, and it sucks you in because it's different. It has that Outer Worlds feel that is so, so good, but you combine that with this Honey, I Shrunk the Kid survival feeling, and it really is an instant sucks you in, gets you playing the game. This game literally is Honey, I Shrunk the Kids meets A Bug's Life, and it's a blast. It's fantastic. Now, the criticism here with this game and these types of game on Xbox and Xbox Game Pass is that these games are not the AAA hardcore single-player games that we've all come to know and love on the PlayStation 5. That is really Microsoft's weakness there. However, Microsoft is taking the strategy this iteration with Game Pass. Game Pass is the new Xbox. Game Pass and xCloud is the next generation of gaming. And with games like this on the Game Pass, I believe Xbox is going to crush it. This is a unique game. It's a fun game. It is a game that will drive players to your Game Pass. Now, that's not to say that Xbox is not going to have the AAA single-player titles. I believe that they are. I think we saw it with Avowed. It is rumored now that Initiative is working on multiple titles, and Aaron Greenberg in an interview yesterday talked a lot about how the Initiative, what they're working on, is akin to Ninja Theory's Hellblade 2 in seriousness, in tone, in graphics, just this next level type of stuff. He did go on to say that when they're ready to show it off, Microsoft is going to work with the Initiative to get, you know, the footage out there and show it off to us. So we know that they're going to have these big AAA titles. I'm not worried about that. I know that's the criticism knocked with this Xbox Game Showcase that, oh, they don't have anything. I think we're going to see it. I think we're going to see some stuff come in August. Also, don't forget that we do have Halo Infinite, which did get knocked for graphics. But if you're a hit, but that is not there to drive new fans necessarily right now at this point. That was there to ensure Halo fans, hey, Halo is here. We're serious about it. We're serious about bringing the spiritual successor to Halo, kind of rebooting it, retooling it for the ground up for next generation. That was the purpose of that game. But games like this, games like Grounded, are perfect to drive new users over to Game Pass. And if they keep coming out with these games, if Obsidian, a quality studio like Obsidian, continues to make these types of first-party Microsoft games for Microsoft, I think Game Pass is going to be really successful. Did you have a chance to play Grounded? I would like to know what your thoughts are. Do you think it's good? Do you think it's a game that can drive people to Game Pass? Let me know in the comments below. Again, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to this channel, and we'll see you guys next time.